Welcome back to Insecurity. We are at RSA 2020 in San Francisco. Some very special guests who have traveled a long way for a presentation today. We have Paula and Dr. Mike from Secure. For the world who may not be fully aware of what you guys are doing, first of all, break it down. What's happening with Secure?
Yeah, first of all, thank you so much for the invitation.
After the podcast, how could we not?
It's such an amazing place. But yeah, just briefly speaking. So Secure, it's a company that has been created 11 years ago. I'm the founder. And here we go. And from now on, we've got 46 people on board, being in 4 locations in the world. So New York, Dubai, Switzerland, and Poland, where HQs are. And yeah, what else to say? We do cybersecurity services. We do cybersecurity research. We are, you can say that, it's technical news. We are the first and the only team in the world that reverse engineered a cryptographic platform in Windows.
Are we breaking news? Is this a thing?
We did it over 2 years ago.
Yeah,
something like that.
Not quite breaking news, but news.
Yeah, but there is like nobody later that did that, so I think it's still breaking.
Now, you have a very interesting thing. I don't know if it's specific to your resume or to Secure as a team, but you have access to the Windows source code.
That's true.
Which I am utterly fascinated by that. And someone asked, I was explaining this earlier today, and she asked me, so what does it even mean? I was like, I don't even know if I really know what that means. What does that even mean?
It means that I'm reading it every day, like when I want to fall asleep.
Really? I'm shocked.
Me too. So yeah, so basically it's absolute honor to get that because it means that Microsoft puts trust in me, so that basically in general in our team, that we are able to contribute to security by knowing what's going on inside the operating system. But you know, like, it's like everything is the source code itself is like so huge. So eventually, like as we were discussing also before this our conversation here, like if you wanna like really like read it, you have to know what you are looking for, because it's so big that you have to only like pick this particular function or this particular like file and so on that you wanna get inside to, and then it takes you hours to understand someone's code because you have to put it in a context. So it's a cool thing to have, but you only get there when you need it, which is not that often.
And Mike, you were saying without breaking any agreements and getting too deep into the complexity, but just it is so complex, but you are only allowed to view bits at a time in order to do the things you're looking to do.
Yeah, you cannot compile it and run it with the debugger to see everything, how it's running there. But for example, we were helping our clients with encrypting file system, and to this extent that we need to look into the source code, seeing how is it working there and how to help them. And even simplest thing that you might think, okay, this is one checkbox in Windows GUI, that it's like a couple hundreds of calls to different functions, different procedures, different files in the operating system. So really it makes life hard to get there, but we do that a lot.
So, yes, the complexity of it keeps it secure, makes it secure. Something else, this is my terrible segue into secure things. You guys do a lot of pen testing and you are, as you said, multiple locations throughout the Middle East and North America. What's a good weird pen testing story? Anybody ever accidentally either get into trouble or get locked in a room they shouldn't have been in?
Oh, multiple times.
Give me some dirt. What do we got?
Okay, so here we go. This is a story that I really like because, well, let me just finish up with the why, because it's the best story. So the story goes like this, that I was pen testing the infrastructure within like a factory environment. So factory environments, they have a one simple characteristic that, well, they are very complex, but they're not always up to date because of the complexity and because of the criticality of various services. So being up to date is not really the most critical thing out there. But there is this guy, and he is actually managing this infrastructure for the past like 20 years. So this is his baby, and it's literally his baby because he comes to work at like 6 o'clock and he leaves at 10, and he's like emotionally attached. Like server room is like his living room, and you
it's
know
his nursery, his where his baby is.
Probably, yeah, exactly. So this is where he has to, like the thing that he has to take care of and all this stuff. So when I was doing the pen test, he was like very disturbed about hurting his baby, as you can imagine. So he was coming in and he was like totally like asking if I managed to get in, and I was like no, and then like 1 hour later he was coming, and then he asked again and I'm like no, and he was like really concerned about this. And when he and I managed actually to get in, He cried. End of story.
Did he cry because you actually broke the system, or because it took so long and he was so proud that it took an expert that long?
No, the first thing.
Okay, yeah, there we go, exactly.
That kid has been hurt. Okay, well, I mean, I'm sorry, this is brutal, but I shouldn't laugh, right? But on the other hand, like, he was like so emotionally related with it, and I'm like, oh, don't worry, like, it's just the pentest, right? And then he was like, yeah, right, but... And then he left the room, he's just like... And for a whole day, he was like...
I love it. Breaking hearts, making grown men cry. Just, think of it, it's like a flu shot. Once you get in, you get that little bit, you're inoculated, now you know what's wrong. All right, for folks that are looking for more information, as we said, you are all over the world, you're doing all kinds of great stuff. When you're not speaking at shows like this, flew across the Atlantic to do one session. That's how much they care. Where can they find out more what's going on with you guys individually, with the company, anything new that's coming out this summer? What do you got?
Well, lots of research.
Yeah.
As always.
Always posting a lot of things on our secureacademy.com/blog.
Yes.
And we also post lots of news there, also from the RSA today.
Yes.
And,
yeah, so basically lots of research. I mean, like pentest as usual, I would say, so that's for sure. But sometimes we've got projects that are incident response related, and these are the ones that are cool. So for, let's say for the summer, we don't know what's going to happen, because for example, last summer, you've been managing this project, so maybe you can share more about that.
Yeah, we've been managing recovery after the incident of ransomware, which are getting more and more advanced as well, more popular to attack the environment. And it was like a project for 16 countries, I think 50 something locations.
Wow.
That
customer gets smashed.
Needed to scramble our teams, the whole team spreading across the Europe and trying to help the client there and to get them up and running again as fast as possible.
These are the people that we are trying to bring to you. If you've got problems, this is where you want to go. I know that you are always out speaking. You were at Microsoft event, I think, what, late this year, right before the podcast, and check out the podcast as well. If people want to follow you guys on the socials, Twitter, LinkedIn, what's happening?
So on Twitter, I'm at Paula Secure, and on Instagram, same thing. And Paula Januszkiewicz, basically, it's a very easy last
yeah,
name.
Januszkiewicz.
Just like
it'll probably be spelled correctly in at least one instance on the blog, but I'm not going to be doing that. Well, we got all kinds of good stuff coming up this week. Please check their stuff out because it really is fascinating. As I said, we did an excellent episode of the Insecurity Podcast with Paula. We're going to be doing that again. Hopefully, Mike will be joining us for that. We might talk about doing yoga in New York. You never know. All the other good stuff, you know, you can find us at BlackBerry and at Silence Inc. ThreatVector.silence.com is where you can get the podcast, the videos, all this good stuff. I'm Matt Stevenson. Look for me at PacMat73. San Francisco, man, we got a lot more good stuff to come.